Am I back?
Yes, you are.
Okay.
That was magical.
Was that you or me?
That was you.
Okay. Anyway, hi, I'm back.
Unfortunately.
Oh, I see how it is.
Well, everyone had for a moment a chance to start hearing the actual in-game noises.
Mm-hmm.
So, yes. Contrary Hurdle is, yeah, he's definitely having some trouble trying to keep up with Solar now.
Yeah. As much, not nearly as much trouble as I am having catching up with him.
And yet, Lone Wolf is having difficulty trying to keep up with you.
Mm-hmm. And then I believe Mr. Shannon's having difficulty catching up with Lone Wolf. And it's just a really spread out field at this point.
Which means there is not a lot of action taking place in Class A. So we're going to go right back to Class B. Well, it looks like a colonel's about to catch up to Gator. We're going to go on board. Well, it should be interesting because the white flag will be coming out for Class A. Actually, it did, so Skoda Boy will be there.
Mm-hmm.
And we're on a bunch of Cajun nuts.
Because why not?
Because I've never heard of Cajun nuts.
So many jokes.
Not enough time to crack.
Nope.
Nope. Not whatsoever. And I just had the most brilliant idea after this. We're not going to stop the stream. We're actually going to take a small break and look up Race 2 from your storefront, Ben.
Yep.
Because why not?
Yeah, why not?
Meanwhile, we're going to go up to the front with Skoda Boy and pals. As Solar has caught up to him. And lap traffic.
Yeah, I believe we are starting to catch the fox at this point. Yes, we are. So now we have two Rockstar cars.
Hey, now Buns you're... Whoa! Almost some contact there between the two.
Yep.
He almost punted that little car off the road! What a meanie. But this is good for Solar. He still has four more turns to catch up, going through the S's. Oh, he is right there on him. However, it's the last turn. Ah, Solar goes over the rumble strip. This is going to slow him down. Mm-hmm. Put him in the draft, though. However, the winner of Race 1 at Nürburgring for Labier is going to go to Skoda Boy with Solar Flare in second and Contrite Hurdle in third. However, we are not going to stop here, folks. We're going to go right to Class B. As a colonel is catching right up to Gator.
Poor Gator.
Okay, I was not imagining things. It does say Marca on the car.
I believe they're Team HCR Murica.
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 Well, there are a bunch of Cajun nuts in Murica. I'm a terrible person. I take full responsibility. And we see Yellowy Chief off in the distance.
Please remember, everyone, that the views and comments made by your commentators do not reflect those of the Toro Racing, the Online Racing Association. The Toro Racing Association.
The nice. Toro is a racing association. However, coming down the front straightaway, checker flag is out for Class B, and it's going to go to a colonel with his teammate Yellowy Chief in second place. And in third will be Easy Team Mako 6669. Alright, so we're going to temporarily black out the stream And we're gonna go hunt ourselves round two. Stay tuned, folks. We will be right... Well, we will be right back with the replay, but we're still here.
Yep.
So, Ben, will you have enough time to do the next round? Or will you have...
I should.
Okay. I would hope so. I'm not saying these races are bad. It's just nice to have someone to talk to. Alrighty, so we're getting ready for race two in just a moment. The laps are still the same, and I believe you guys are going to be doing another grid setup.
Yeah, I think so. I'm trying to remember. Yeah, I think we are just going to go... We are going to do another parade... Yeah, we are going to do another parade lap. Just so we can get set up. And because this is the VIG Trophy Cup, whatever you want to call this series.
You had it.
So the VIG Trophy. We do another race that is the results from the previous race. Unlike other series where we've did reverse grids, this one graciously does not have one like that.
And graciously, this does not have a third round.
Exactly.
Well, I'd just say a third race for the round, because I would probably get fed up taking pictures at this point. Alright, so it's Gota Boy taking the win for Class A, and a Colonel for Class B. You think they'll pull it off here without spoiling anything?
Skoda is going to have Solar on his bumper, and that's pretty much not a spoiler. We all know that that's how Skoller rolls. I did it again. That's
Hashtag Skoller.
That's how Solar rolls. He pushes you so hard that eventually you make a mistake and he can just get by you.
Solar in his rollers.
But Skoda Boy is a tough customer to pass, so I've been told.
Well, I think it's about time to start the grid music as reasons, so without further ado...
It's time to start the music, it's time to let... Sorry.
And tuning out Ben for the second race, Skoda Boy on the pole, and next to him will be HTR Sola. In row two is Contre Hurdle and Big Ben. Row three has Lone Wolf 8646 and Mr. Shannon to you. Row 4, the last row for Class A is going to be John Galt and Gator. In Class B for the pole will be a Colonel. Next to him will be his teammate, Yellowy Chief. And next to them in Row 2 is EZT Mako 6669 and EZT Coot. And in last place is Tyrannic Symbols. That concludes your Class A and B grid for the finale of Nürburgring Grand Prix. I do not also hold accountability for blowing out your ears.
Sorry.
So, Scotty Boy, Sola, and Contrite Hurdle, first, second, and third.
It's the HCR lobby all over again.
Welcome to the HCR TCC.
Well, HCR VAG.
Happy
it's
Cats Racing.
Acronyms and letters everywhere.
Yes, VAG is Volkswagen Volkswagen Audi German Trophy Cup? Yeah, okay.
I'm guessing.
Alright. Because they're both German-manufactured vehicles.
And Audi is owned by Volkswagen.
That's just like a slap to the face.
Volkswagen owns Porsche and Lamborghini as well.
And that's why EA never allows anybody to have Porsche. They give us rough instead.
Exactly. Electronic Arts, please, for the fans, let us have Porsche as another.
And Skoda Boy takes out a series of cones. And he takes out more cones! What are you doing, Skoda Boy? Showing off to the fans at home?
I believe he was trying to warm up his tires by doing a drift, and you saw the result.
Well, He's... Oh, no, wait. The Rockstar livery is backwards. I spoke too soon. Because the cat vinyl
is... It's annoying. As a someone who does designs, it's annoying that it's reverse.
And Skodaboy is going to pull a solar and stop right at the start-finish line. However, he is perpendicular to the starting grid marker.
Yeah.
Oh yes, I just remembered. News update. Project Cars has been pushed to June.
Of course it has.
This is news to me. Thank you, Lewis Satterley, for posting the news. Mm-hmm. Well, it's a good thing I've only put $15 down on the game. Please.
Hopefully this will all be worth it, because I feel we all feel the same way, that it's better for a developer to make sure everything works so we don't get another Forza 5.
I don't want a Gran Turismo 5 where the game comes out 5 years later. Actually, longer. Yeah, okay. Because we don't know exactly what else they're trying to fix and make sure that it's a perfect product. I'm more worried that the longer this is taking, other corporations, companies, are going to take what they have and make it better.
Mm.
And then Project Cars won't be special.
Could also be, well, we've started, so hold that thought.
Yes. That'll shape me up in the middle of the field. However, we're still focusing up front as Solar is gained second place from Contre Hurl and a battle between Ben and Lone Wolf.
Yeah, Lone Wolf scared me at the beginning. I went really far to the inside of the corner to try to get a line around Contrite, then all of a sudden, oh look, Lone Wolf's beside me.
Now, did he give you a heads up that he was right next to you, or did he just... It was too late by then.
It was too late by then. It was one of the situations where he was literally opening his mouth to say something, and then I hit him. It was a light tap, but still.
That doesn't seem to be slowing you guys down much in the slightest.
Nope.
And it looks like Gator's going to try and
very, very light tap. However, go back to me real quick. real quick.
I'm going. Jeez.
Okay.
Okay, here I am. What am I seeing?
I get all of your points for that.
You get no points. You got hit. You got hit, boy. Okay, I'm going away from you now. Yellowy Chief is still in first place with his teammate behind in second, and a battle shaping up between Tyrannic Symbols and Mako. Or there was.
Oop. Sorry, I keep doing that.
Okay. Tyrannic Symbols has moved into fourth place for Class B.
Who's behind him?
That would be Coot.
Okay. I'm gonna guess Coot had an off somewhere on the track.
Well, unfortunately, that little Volkswagen is very slow on the straights. This will allow Coot to catch up.
We have a braking battle going into the chicane.
I'm not gonna lie, this car looks very cartoonish when it takes the turns.
The Fox?
Yes.
Yeah. What would you expect from a car named Fox?
A copyright. Meanwhile, Drag Race on the front straightaway going into turn one. Symbols is gonna hold the outside line, and Coot's gonna come back on the inside. However, denied.
Yeah, I think Tyrannix is not going to let Coot by him easily just because, oh, look, he's ahead of someone. I know that's kind of mean, but still.
Hey, that's a plus for him. He gets points in the Class B division.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, Team Marika, first and second place. And poor Gator in front of them.
Mm-hmm.
So, are we expecting to see a battle for first and second place once again between these two?
I don't remember for certain, so probably.
I'm just going to back away from Class B and see how Class A is doing.
You're going to want to pay attention to Solar and Skoda, or...
Oh, you mean right here? Battle for the lead? Humping
yep.
over the rumble strip there, Solar? Huh? Huh? It's a little ballsy right there of you, bud. That would have been great for Contrite.
From what you know of Solar, does that not surprise you that he would try to make that move? The guy is daring at a car.
Well, if he tuned the car, he knows the limits of that machine.
Yep.
And after racing one of his builds, I hate the braking. It's like I lightly press the brake button, all of a sudden the car comes to a stop. I'm like, seriously?
Yeah. Yeah, Sora likes to tune heavy brake biases.
I have to do mid. I actually pump the brake.
Mm-hmm.
Anyways, coming down to turn one.
To be able to drive the Scirocco, I had completely changed their brake pressure so I could actually drive it.
Yeah. Like, the alignment, the suspension, the downforce are beautiful. But mm-hmm. it's the braking. And
it's
maybe the gear
the
ratio.
Everyone tunes differently, so.
That is true.
So, you have to, though, it's Solar, so that brake pressure must be doing something for him.
Alright, and let's check out the Ben and Bone Wolf show. Okay, not much happening.
No, not much happened in this race, besides that little tap at the beginning, was a little bit more calm between me and Lone Wolf.
And
at one point, he was saying, "No, Ben, come back! I want to play!"
Nice.
My only response was, "I must go. My people need me."
And the battle shaping up with Gator slowing down both of the Volkswagens. And he breaks in the middle. This is going to allow Yellowy Chief and a Colonel to put on a great show here coming up through, I think it's turn six?
Something like that.
Well, it's definitely shaping up here.
I'll be interested to see how quickly the greater horsepower of... I don't remember what Satay Gator's in, but how to see how much horsepower much the horsepower difference is going to make. He's probably going to catch them on that long run down towards the chicane in the last couple corners. If not, catch them a little bit during this section here.
Oh, the Schumacher S?
Yeah.
Well, speaking of catch-up, a Colonel has now used the Schumacher S to slip up.
A love tap there.
That wasn't even much of a love tap. That was like a peck on the cheek.
Mm-hmm.
They have a flame vinyl on the exhaust?
Alright, indeed they do.
At this point, they are bump drafting, and they actually changed the color of the rims on the car, on their tires. That is very smart.
Mm-hmm.
And one of them does not have a number box on the side.
They fix it eventually.
Yeah, well... Sorry, too late to penalize them for that. I'm sure they've already been told.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, so we're about halfway done here at Nürburgring Grand Prix, round two. Focusing on Class B with Gator stuck in the middle.
I'm surprised Gator hasn't really used the horsepower advantage to his advantage here, but he might be having some trouble with the cording speeds of the Satay.
Probably wasn't tuned properly. Then again, I would not know anything.
Me either. I'm okay. I'm not a great tuner, though.
Alright, looks like Gator is trying to keep up with both of them. And we're just going to quickly switch up to the front and see if anything else is going on. As Skoda Boy still leads the race, with Solar right in tow. It's like nothing happened.
Yes, Solar is hungry for this win now because he couldn't quite get past Skoda during the first heat round. What do you want to call them? The race.
Yeah, first race.
He's just going to hound Skoda Boy the entire rest of this race.
Well, we definitely notice that he slows down a bit going over the rumble strip after exiting the Coca-Cola curve. I believe it's still called that. Now, going back to Contrite Hurdle, is this his first Tour Series? I cannot remember if he's actually participated in previous events.
You know, I don't know. I haven't ever seen his gamer tag either before, but I do know he's a member of HCR, so this might be his first one in a while. But then again, I've only been racing a Tour for less than 6 months, so.
Hey, before you know it, another year, you'll be an old timer. ORD, Old Racing Demons.
Well, considering I'm one of, there's only three of us, and we're all roughly the same age, that's going to take a while. Arguably, though, Tony is, oh, the lobster is already a demon, so.
And he is your mechanic.
And he's my mechanic. I'll be watching my cars from now on, considering I just said that.
If he hears this, that is your problem.
Yeah.
And if both cars go through the
Schumacher. Just call me a Moffat and we'll move on.
Sure, why not? Two more laps to go here, and Solar almost made contact with Skoda Boy to swerve out of the way to avoid making contact with him.
These two are really going at it. It's becoming the battle of the braking here, going up into the chicane.
It's going to be a game of chicken, and Solar Flare Black backs off.
Wisely, probably.
Oh, and coming down through the Coca-Cola curve?
He's got the line.
It's going to be very close. They're still neck and neck coming down the front straightaway. Ooh, Skoda Boy and Solar make contact.
Ooh.
Two laps to go. Yeah, Solar's definitely getting desperate.
And he's definitely providing some great entertainment.
Oh, he's going to try to pass on the outside line going through turn one, and it did not work.
I'm surprised Skoller didn't try to do a cutback there.
You just said Skoller again.
Dang it. Solar.
Hashtag Skoller.
Sorry, guys.
We are now on board with Solar. As he
or
is...
Or Skoller.
We were on Skoda Boy for a moment. And because I have this weird premonition, we're going to go back to Class B. And Gator has gotten past both Yellowy Chief and a Colonel. Nice.
Yep. That horsepower advantage had to take hold sometime.
Those two are the stars here in Class B. And right back up to Class A. And it looks like Solar is cutting corners. I could be wrong.
He is playing a little bit close with those curbs, but I don't believe any swords action has been taken.
And it's not like he's using it to try to pass Skoda Boy.
Yeah.
So I think he'll be okay.
Yep.
And poor Contrite off in the distance, forever alone.
I'm pretty much forever alone as well at this point. And so is Lone Wolf, and so is basically everybody else in A-Class.
On the front bumper cam of HCR Solar, with the white flag coming out momentarily. Well, if Solar wants to do something and try to get a win here, he has to do it now.
Yep. There's a lot of overtaking opportunities on this track. He's just going to find one that will work.
And he always said he doesn't get enough screen time. Well, he's getting enough of it today.
Happy now?
No, he will. Don't worry, there will be more future races with him, so he will definitely be getting attention. Skoda Boy is cutting Solar off, it looks like.
Yeah, considering the amount that Solar has closed on Skoda just in the first section here, it's pretty much showing you how much Skoda is going to have to work if he wants to keep Solar behind him for the rest of the lap and be able to secure his win. There's a really great overtaking opportunity going up into this hairpin.
And Solar's just going to keep his distance. However, he's in the draft line of Skoda coming up towards the Schumacher S.
You can, with the car the way Solar has it tuned, you can pretty much fly through there as fast as you dare go. It grips very well, however, you have to lift a little bit. And with this corner, you have to brake really hard to be able to slow it down. Well, for this next one, you can just lift and then smash it as quick as you can to be able to get a good run down this straight.
They are now on the back stretch, and Solar is running out of time.
Running out of time and distance.
Going through the chicane, and it looks like he doesn't have it here. One more turn.
This is a repeat of the last race.
Oh, Solar digs deep on the inside. And he goes off the rumble strip again. This is going to slow him down. However, the winner of race two, back-to-back, is going to go to Skoda Boy with Solar in second place. Kondrej is going to get third. Meanwhile, in Class B, well, it's still Gator up in front of them. Still focused on both the LV Chief and a Colonel. Oh, Tyrannic Simples has dropped back to last place, so he has lost position to Coot. So that means EZT and both the OE Chief and a Colonel. Teams in their own rights. I think at this point it doesn't matter who wins here in Class B because both will be getting points in the team standings.
Yeah. However, they're probably going after it just for bragging rights.
Well, they are getting live stream for it, so I think kudos to them.
Yep.
Oh, it looks like Yellow Chief is going to block his teammate, even though Colonel has the acceleration going through the straights, and Yellow Chief has the handling through the turns. He's really close up on his bumper coming down through the last turn. And on the front straightaway, they're side by side. However, Yellowy Chief is going to have the distance, and coming by on a long shot, checker flag is in the air, and Yellowy Chief holds off his teammate, a Colonel, for second. And in third, we'll go to EZT Mako 6669. All right, folks, we're going to stop the stream temporarily and get ready for some Japanese racing at Suzuka. Be right back.